Hello everyone. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Kennedy and I had the privilege of being Kids Hub's first president. So I'm very excited about this 5-year milestone, not just because it's 5 years, which is amazing all by itself, but because of the quality of that time and because of Kids Hub's persistent commitment to that mission of giving youth a global voice. Any hubber, anyone who is affiliated with Kids Hub knows that that notion of giving youth a global voice is central and omnipresent. So I'd like to encourage everyone to think about what giving youth a global voice means in 2015. As a hubber, I began to learn that we live in a world where very few are privileged with the opportunity to speak aloud, to truly speak aloud, to use themselves as the springboard to spark the conversation, let alone any young person having this opportunity. So Kids Hub's mission is unique and is absolutely to be celebrated. As a hubber, I was able to conduct the Kids Hub Book Club. What that meant was that I had a segment during which I would choose my favorite book for that month or for that several week time, and I get to pick the way I would frame it. So I would do either a summary or I'd do a series of questions or I would take a lesson from those chapters and try to connect it to my life as a young person. And in the beginning, I felt that I was really just sharing my love for reading and some of my favorite classic novels with my peers and encouraging them to pick up the book or to offer their own opinions and to really think critically on their own. But I quickly began to realize that it was more than sharing summaries from my favorite books. It was more than me doing character lists and drawing comparisons between myself and the characters in these books. It was really me having the opportunity to reshape what it meant to have leisurely time as a young person and to turn it into something that was academic but still just as enjoyable. To really reshape what it meant to be smart. To reshape what it meant to take initiative and to encourage my peers to grab a book and enjoy it, not necessarily needing a teacher in the front of the classroom to dictate that process for them, and to really take hold of their own education and to enjoy the opportunity to read and really turn it into something that was personal, that was their own, and that could be absolutely independent. And this is a pattern that you see time and time again at Kids Hub. It's young people who have a passion for one thing or another and really bringing their talents to light. But the key there is that they're able to realize that they're a part of something that is bigger than themselves, that it's not just a matter of them doing their favorite hobby one afternoon, but it's that sharing aspect of it, of a community of young people who are absolutely enlightened by their own talents and sharing that with other people. So you might be wondering what exactly I think the global aspect of Kids Hub is, because I've shared the idea of it giving youth a voice, and absolutely Kids Hub gives youth a voice, as I've just explained. But what about Kids Hub is global? Why is it giving youth a global voice? And how exactly do you make a voice global? And I think Kids Hub has done this in a literal way, but also in a more symbolic way. So Kids Hub has absolutely gone global. It is beyond the United States borders. It has really touched youth all over and has been able to bridge connections through youth who are passionate and talented and willing to share and able to encourage their peers to share as well. But it's also global in another sense. As I continued with the Kids Hub Book Club segment, I began to realize through the characteristics of these books that I was sharing that being a young person is a universal experience. Every single person goes through youth at some point. And of course, we live in a really diverse world where, you know, political context or social context really shape what it is like to be a young person. But overall, there's this notion of the older generation running the world and giving the torch to the younger generation at some point or another, and the younger generation really following suit. Now, Kids Hub challenges this idea and shakes it up a little bit and says, what if you still have the older generations guiding youth, but really giving them the torch a little bit earlier, really showing them that they have the power to shape their own generation and redefine what it means to be intelligent, to redefine what it means to be creative, to redefine what it means to have a voice, something that's just beyond word of mouth or social media, and most importantly, to empower one another. I realized at some point while I was doing the book club that it really wasn't just about me getting my peers to love doing what I was doing, which was reading in my free time and really bridging a connection between myself and the characters, but empowering them to take something that they loved and empower their friends, whether that be athletics or fashion or art, to realize that your talent in itself gives you a voice because it makes you unique and it gives you power. So that is what Kids Hub continues to encourage young people to do, and to also be the voice of their generation, not to wait on anyone to take initiative and to lead and to find your talents and to share them and to realize that you do contribute to this fabric of talent that exists. So I am incredibly proud of Kids Hub for this 5-year milestone. I am overly excited for what Kids Hub has in the future. So this is to the next 100 years of Kids Hub continuing to give you the global voice and reshaping and redefining what it means to be a young person.
Hello, everybody. My name is Brandon Grant, junior broadcaster of the Kids Hub Media Network. Now, there's a lot of Kids Hubbers across the country, including New York, New Jersey, and Connecticut. But coming up now is a girl who is from Connecticut. Please give it up for Ariana on the sax.